Sega! Hello, I'm Duke of the Mump, and this is Let's Play Popful Mail, Redux. An exciting Let's Play adventure brought to you by Kim, the first donor in my request donation drive. And I know some of you are going to want to watch the intro, so I will shut up. I'll put a link if you want to skip it.
Carvings upon the great stone wall at Shikra tell of a time beyond memory, a time of world-shattering war, when the brave and the desperate rose up against the three masters of evil. They were Morgul, lord of beasts, who sent savage armies over the land. Necros, master of war, who incited all man to rage eternal. And Ulgur, the overlord, who blackened the world with his foul magic. Men and elves, dwarves and beasts, all inhabitants of the world were locked in hopeless, fevered battle against a black fate. Raging like a great fire, insanity swept across the land with the ferocity unmatched in all history. But when at last the smoke had cleared, the masters of evil had suffered a crushing defeat. Humiliated, they retreated to a place outside of time, and a black seal was crafted to prevent their return. Of all who fought, only three returned to tell the story: a dwarf, an elf, and a human. Though their names were lost in the mists of time, their labor stands yet today, for the black seal holds fast, protecting mankind from certain destruction at the hand of the Overlord.
All right, that was very exciting. Let us get on with the actual game now. Good old gameplay, ahoy. 100% gameplay coming at you. Oh, wait, another cutscene.
I got you now, you little criminals! Hold and surrender! You little freaks of nature don't stand a chance! Give it up! Eat this, cookie face! Get a load of this, you miscreants! Take that! Yes! Cracker, your choice. Dead or alive, I still get the 500,000 gold reward.
Hey, you are a real funny girl. You make me laugh. Hey, you like a good joke? Ha! Boomba! Bumba, you want my head? Oh, help yourself! Here's a funny trick, eh? Get ready for a big surprise!
Uh, least I managed to get his head. It has to be worth something. Oh, I wonder if I'm even cut out to be a bounty hunter at all. But if I don't get some cash soon, I'm gonna be in big trouble. There's gotta be another bounty I can go after. My luck's gotta change soon. Wow, a city. Maybe I can sell Nut's head down there. For a big bounty, and I only take the best jobs.
You might be in luck. A new poster just went up on the town's bounty board. A renegade magician turning some bad tricks. Got an uncommon big reward on him.
Great! Thanks for the tip! Move it! Coming through! Step aside! For the capture of the notorious magician Muttonhead, a reward is offered in the sum of 2 million gold. Woohoo! This is my lucky day! I'm gonna be rich!
All right, and that was our introduction to the eponymous hero of the game, Popful Male. Definitely not Lena from Slayers, a totally original character made by Falcom, localized by Legends of Localization Working Designs. This is the Elf Woods, not to be confused with Elfwood, the fantasy art site. Is that site still around? I remember that being like a big deal back in the early 2000s. It was like DeviantArt, but for fantasy. Like, every fantasy artist worth their salt had an Elfwood page. I should really go back and check that. There's some good stuff on there. So yeah, we're on our way to the Elf Village. Lots of great gameplay. Oh.
Hey! Hey you! Help!
What was that? It sounded like...
Are you blind or something? Up in the tree, a dunderhead!
Huh? Oh! What in the world are you doing up there?
Well, there were all these monsters chasing me. There must have been 100 of them, and they had bulging eyes and huge teeth, and then they chased me up this tree, and then the spider dropped down. He almost killed me, but I cut his thread. I have a pocket knife, you know, and then, well, I don't think it's safe to come down. Oh, by the way, I'm Slick. Well, actually, Slick Jr. the Third. But you can call me Slick. I'm from the village at the bottom of the jungle. Say, can you give me some help here? Like, today?
Well, Slick, why'd you leave your village in the first place?
Hey, I was just looking for a little fun and adventure. But I guess my pocket knife just doesn't cut it out here. Say, why do you take me with you? I bet you have lots of adventures. Why else would you have such a huge sword?
Excuse me? I think you're confused. I'm a bounty hunter, not a babysitter, bub. You're on your own.
I love Slick's little happy face there, with his ears wiggling back and forth like a puppy. It's adorable. So yeah, this is Popful Male. Redux. Or is it redo? Like a French word. I don't know. I'm not sure I've ever actually heard the word pronounced. I've only read it. R-E-D-U-X. It might be redo. Well, in any case, for me, this will be both a redux and a redo. Oops. I've had some bad luck trying to LP this game in the past. The first time, I made it up to video 14, and my computer died shortly afterward. And that that discouraged me from streaming it for a long time. And I tried to stream it to, you know, try to get back to where I was before, and the ROM messed up on me. Since I'm playing in an emulator, I don't actually own a Sega CD or the software necessary to capture it. Oh, this must be the Elf Village. So yeah, I always meant to come back to... Oh, wait.
Another slick caper, eh? What has he done this time? Just the facts, man.
Well, let's see. Monsters chased him up a tree. Now the dumb kid's too scared to come down. And he's waiting for your help.
Sounds like a second story job. We'll take it from here, ma'am.
Ma'am? How old does that dude think I am? I mean, Popful Mail can be older than what, like 17? This is a Japanese game after all. Not that I'm stereotyping the Japanese, but especially in this era. I'm healing cost 1 gold per hit point you want to heal. So it's only 10, not bad. In this shop we can buy an amulet, which will I believe make you temporarily invincible, but you can't attack. The orange, any fruit you find is going to heal you to a different degree. I don't need any of that right now. No, oh yeah, I found them, but I did not really care. What you got? Short sword, that's what I have. Leather mail, I need that. And I need the wood shield. I can't afford the mail, I'll go ahead and buy the wood shield. 400 gold. I will go in and equip that. So here's what we have, a short sword, a wood shield, which I just bought, and an apple. Apples heal 60 hit points, I believe. And an elixir will revive us if we die. Now, the save system in this game is pretty generous, so I am going to be making good use of that. You can save anytime the screen transitions, and it'll save your progress. So, for example, if I left the screen and went into a different area, I could save there. I'll probably be doing that every time. Strange to have visitors, huh? Well, I wonder why. You're at the bottom of the freaking forest. Not everyone wants to drop down a 50-foot hole to visit Elf Town. Visit your glamorous fruit shop and weapon shop. I mean, come on, you guys don't even have a movie theater. You should really take some steps to buff up your tourism industry. And your soldiers, totally useless. Because of that, we're pretty poor swordsmen. Well, yeah, I think so, since you have spears, not swords. Are you a good spearman? Because that's what you need to be. So yeah, I've tested this ROM, and it... Oh, 1 second.
Well, hi! What brings you here, stranger?
I'm Mail, Popful Mail. You see, I'm looking for a magician called Muttonhead. There's a bounty of 2 million gold on his head.
Oh, well, you're on the right path, because I saw that rotten gingerbread grifter gang pass this way. They're in league with Muttonhead, you know.
What? They were here and you let them get away? Where are they? Which way did they go?
Calm down, Mail. I'm after those crooks too. By the way, I'm Namo. If you happen to find them, let me know and I'll help you nab them.
Oh, sure. And let you get the reward? Nice try, Haystack.
Well, I'll tell you, Bounty Hunter. I'm very strong. Just keep me in mind, okay?
I'm very strong. I love being strong. Yeah, that was Namo. I don't know if we'll see him again for a while. Now Slick we'll see all over the freaking place. You can't get rid of that guy. Our first goal is to... Well, our ultimate goal is to locate Muttonhead. We are chasing down his trail now. And, it's pretty typical fantasy setup. Wandering adventurer looking for jobs as a source of income. Checking the bounty board, seeing who she can go beat up. It's much like the opening to many a Dungeons & Dragons game. And Mail is a pretty typical Dungeons & Dragons character. A lot of people like playing really focused treasure hunters, especially people who don't like role-playing that much, since it's an easy character to play. You have a clearly defined motivation, you know what you're after. This is a difficult game, which is why I'm going to save early and save often. The controls in this game, well, especially with Popful Mail, the controls, they're a little fast, you tend to move a little faster than you're able to react to stuff with Popful Mail. Other characters, the speed is a little bit more reasonable. So I tend to play very carefully until I unlock the other characters. Spoiler alert, you play as other characters in this game, which if you watched the previous videos, you'd have seen at least one of them. Tat the Magician, or Tat, or Tato, or however the game pronounces it. Oh, shite. Now, like I said, right now we only have one apple for healing. Now, we can always go back to the town and heal up. That's the cheapest way to do it. Much cheaper than what the fruit would cost if you do heal with fruit. I like this game, don't get me wrong. It has a certain weird 90s charm to it because of the localization. Working Designs was pretty notorious for really cheesy kind of translations. And there are a lot of references in this game that don't make sense at all. Let's jump down here and see what we find. Oh, look at that. An orange. Notable because nothing rhymes with it. So yeah, a lot of the anachronistic references are really dumb and cheesy, but I kind of like it because of that, not in spite of it. It just gives it this dumb, quirky kind of charm. You didn't see much of that in my previous playthrough because I really didn't make it that far. This game's a lot longer than I remember it. I didn't beat it when I was practicing, but I did make it pretty damn far, and I looked up the walkthrough just to see how long the game was, because I have beaten it, and it must have taken me a very long time because I was my clock said about 5 hours. But it was really much more than that from restarting all the time. There's nothing here now, but there will be an optional quest when we come back here later. Let's leave and go on ahead and save, since that counts as a... let's save in here, because I believe if we save outside and we load the save, it'll start us back at the beginning of this area. But this way we have a sort of a halfway point almost. But yeah, my game clock said about 5 hours, and I was about halfway through. So, longer than you might expect. And there's kind of a lot of backtracking in the game. It presents itself like a Metroidvania almost, like sort of open world-ish. But there's really not a lot of openness to it.
Hello there! Say, I watched you slash your way up here. Most impressive, I must admit. Who are you?
I'm Mail, Popful Mail. Right now I'm after a dangerous magician called Muttonhead. There's a big reward for him.
Oh? Muttonhead used to be my teacher. He was once a kind and wonderful person. But then, all of a sudden, he turned evil.
Storytelling gold.
I can't find out what went wrong. Actually, I should say I was going after him, but the monster just ahead stopped me dead in my tracks. He's much too powerful for my simple scepter.
Don't worry. I'm sure I can take him. I've had a lot of practice lately. This shouldn't take long.
Okay. Well, be careful. Let me know when it's all clear, okay?
It's ironic, because when you do get Tat in your party, his starting weapon is better than your sword by a long shot. Alright, let's go ahead and save up here. This will be the first boss, so I will get through this, and then I will call it a day. The Mad Bomber. Now, most of the bosses in this game, you pretty much have to cheese them if you want a chance of surviving. And in this case, it means standing under this platform, popping out once or twice to hit him, and then hiding under the platform again. Because he just sticks to this predefined pattern. He doesn't drift from it or do anything that would mess up your plan. And it's tedious, but it's safe. And that's the important thing. Because I imagine one of those bombs would pretty much... Well, two bombs would kill me, definitely. One bomb would put me in a bad position. Because you don't have a lot of hit invincibility time in this game. And a lot of times, if you get hit once, you're just screwed. Because you just get... Well, you get stunlocked in a lot of situations. And that didn't take too long. Destroy the evil Midnight Bomber. What bombs at midnight? Oh, and it heals you up after every boss, which is nice. Heard the passage blockage crumble. Now, we could just go on ahead and be a dick to our friend we just met, but let's go back and tell him what the score is.
Wow! You destroyed the Mad Bomber! Now I can get on with the search for my master.
Didn't I say he'd be a piece of cake? I don't kid around when it comes to a fight.
Well, as I said, your skills are quite impressive. By the way, I'm Tat, apprentice magician extraordinaire. Hopefully, we'll meet again soon.
Oh, I'm sure we will. And that'll do it for this edition of Let's Play Popful Mail Redux. Tune in tomorrow for the next exciting chapter. I'm Duke of the Bump, and I will see you later.